watching KTAL News Now. Here's Brittany DeFran with your midday news break.
Welcome to KTAL News Now. I'm Brittany DeFran. Let's get into today's midday news break. Here is news no family wants to hear, especially around the holidays. Louisiana State Police say Tyron Williams, Dylan Young, and Broderick Moore, all from Texas, were killed in Natchitoches while changing a flat tire along the interstate. It happened around 7 on Tuesday night when an 18-wheeler drifted and hit the students. All three died at the scene. The driver, 62-year-old Clyde Gray of Coushatta, was not injured.
It's so tragic, it's hard to even talk about. Right. It's just that tragic. It's just a very, very dangerous situation all the way around, because you got people traveling at a high rate of speed. You have people traveling over open country. They get tired. They get fatigued. They get distracted.
The students attended Southern University of Baton Rouge and were members in the Human Jukebox band. Williams and Moore were freshmen majoring in music. Young was a sophomore majoring in mechanical engineering. Now, this is just sad because they were actually heading home to Dallas, Texas for the holidays. Okay, take a listen to this. For the first time since interim leadership took over the Louisiana Department of Children and Family Services, they have now reported to state lawmakers how they are implementing change. A recent survey by the Legislative Auditor's Office found that DCFS workers feel there are major issues with pay, workload, and respect in the workplace. Lawmakers press them on their priorities as they deal with the recent crisis of children dying under DCFS's watch.
Number one is the timely assessment of the children that come in through the intake. And that is what drives everything else on here, actually. All of the retention and recruitment work is to drive being able to have timely assessments.
And contractors have been hired in some regions to handle overnight shifts, and recruitment events have helped fill gaps across the state. NBC6 is your local election headquarters, and here is something I've never seen before. The mayor-elect of a town in Arkansas just graduated high school this year. Jalen Smith is only 18 years old, and he'll be the youngest black mayor in the U.S. Smith won a mayoral runoff in Earl, Arkansas on Tuesday. Earl has a population of 1,800. Smith defeated his opponent, Nemi Matthews Sr., by fewer than 80 votes. Wow, now that is an accomplishment, and Smith says he wanted to start early because no matter what, everyone has to start somewhere. He didn't want to wait until he was 30 or 40 to run for mayor. That is so amazing. Congratulations to him. Now, turning to your medical headlines, a new study shows that cannabis abuse in adolescents has increased by 245% since the year 2000. The National Poison Data System found more than 330,000 reports of cannabis abuse in American children, and this is happening between ages 6 and 18. Marijuana exposure cases remained stable from 2000 to 2009, then steadily rose from 2011 before dramatically going up in 2017. The study says the dramatic uptick coincides with the wave of decriminalization actually in the U.S. And now this is going to lead us to our question of the day, because we want to hear from you on this topic. Going to give you a moment to take down this QR code you see right here on your screen. All right, and as we are discussing this, a new study that shows that there has been an uptick in adolescents abusing marijuana, cannabis, and you know, they say that this coincides with decriminalization of it as well. We wanted to hear from you. Do you think that recreational marijuana will be legal in the Arklatex within the next 5 years? We know that it was on the ballot for Arkansas, which did not pass, but we wanted to hear from you on this topic. It looks like 80% say yes and 20% say no. That's all for now, but don't go anywhere. More to come on your midday news break. Thanks for sticking around. I'm Brittany DeFran with more on your Midday News Break. Starting off with a story in the Christmas spirit, a Texarkana organization needs your help this holiday bringing some joy to children affected by domestic violence. Domestic Violence Prevention Incorporated wants to provide Christmas presents for about 400 children with their Santa store. This allows their clients to shop for their children, and this year the organization says they need about 30,000 in donations to make the Santa store a success.
During the Christmas season, we have that school break, right? And all these kids will go home and they have these awesome Christmases. And then they come into the new year and they're all comparing toys and what they got for Christmas. And I got this 5-foot-tall Frozen doll or whatever it is. And, you know, if they didn't get anything for Christmas, they won't get to share that at school. So they're going to be the outcast.
From now through Friday, you can drop off donations of money or toys at the office located on Spruce Street in Texarkana, Texas. Sustaining Hope Breakfast is on a mission to remind people that homeless is real in North Louisiana. Hope Connection hosted the event in First United Methodist Church in downtown Shreveport to explain the issues people face. Members of the audience read stories about real people experiencing homelessness right here in Shreveport. Several people received awards for their dedication to helping those who are homeless. Hope Connection also shared that it's a new emergency shelter will be complete in February. That's awesome and a great way to provide a home for a lot of people in need. Now, more on recreational marijuana here. As Responsible Growth Arkansas has collected more than 190,000 signatures in support of recreational marijuana. On election day, 56% of the voters were against it. Arkansas lawmakers on both sides of the aisle ended up coming out against the ballot issue 4. Most of the opposition came from Republicans, but Democrat State Senator Greg Letting also tweeted against it. He said it limited the number of companies who could participate and ended the requirement for the majority to be Arkansas-based. And so it was just really interesting that those companies were limited, and then he kind of ended that. Now, the question is, will lawmakers take this issue up in the upcoming legislative session? So we'll be watching that. Some, like Misty Orpin from Common Ground Arkansas, believe we might not see this topic come up. Now, ballot measures for constitutional amendments only require a simple majority vote for approval. So we will see if Arkansas lawmakers put up another ballot issue to increase it to a supermajority vote of 60%. Now, the ballot issue is also, it failed during the midterm election with more than 59% voting against it. And the Arkansas legislative session starts January 9th, so we'll be sure to keep an eye on that and tell you guys more on that. So let's jump into our question of the day. All right, we're going to give you a moment to take down this QR code you see right here. Remaining on the topic of recreational marijuana and cannabis, do you think that recreational marijuana will be legal in the Arklatex within the next 5 years? Tell us what you think here. It looks like 80% say yes, but 20% say no. For more details on these stories, head to ktalnews.com or download the KTAL News Now app for push notifications. Have a great day, you guys. See you next time.